Good evening, everyone. The first topic is related with civil servant. Joining politics. This topic comes every 5 years. When either election is near, means basically Lok Sabha election is near. So that is how it comes into. So almost let's say that in 2014 also there was a debate. And the same debate is also going to be in 2018 and 19. So, although they have not asked any question, etc., but you should know such debates. Basically, what has happened that when election comes, so serving IAS officers, IAS means their brethren, etc., you can take, their fraternity rather. So they quit their service and join, let's say, politics. Should it be a matter of concern? This is how it is. It is not, let's say, new. Civil servants have been serving to politics. And the very prominent example is Subhash Chandra Bose. So he also quit civil services and joined politics. So if you take from that to, we have also Ajit Jogi, right, example. And then the most recent debate is because of O.P. Chaudhary. So this debate is in 2018-19, it will be O.P. Chaudhary. So he will become a reference point. Who was also awarded, let's say, in 2012. That's a public administration award, which is instituted in service to civil services, excellence in civil services. So he was given award this time. Young officer, he had completed 11 years of his service. So he can be considered among the youngest civil servant to join politics. He had almost 11 years of service. And then let's say he was to be, let's say that, sent to secretariat. His field service was ending. So his field service was ending, therefore this is another, let's say that, dimension. So he did not like to go to secretariat. He wanted to remain in public glare. Right. This is how it is. So he says that if I go to secretariat, so I will have to issue order, etc. I will not be in public contact, etc. And therefore I will not be able to serve two people. It means those who are in secretariat, they don't serve two people. So this is how it is. He wants to remain in contact with people, right? But let's say when he goes in, let's say he will become MLA. So when he become MLA, he will become minister. So even he goes superior to above secretariat, right? So technically his words are not sound. He may be a sound person. So basically he will go to minister. He will become a superior functionary. And when he becomes a further superior functionary, his role will be of policy making. His role will be of policy making. But he says he will remain in contact with people, he wants to serve to people. Second, any MLA is, let's say, so MLA, so he is a representative of people in entire state. Or MP, so he is representative of people in entire country. He is not necessarily representative of that constituency. This is how the spirit of democracy. The spirit of democracy also says that any MP or MLA should not work for only his constituency. Rather, he should work for the country. Isn't it? So even if he has not visited his constituency once in a 5 year, in India it is a matter for people, but in theory it should not be a matter. In principle it should not be a matter, because a lawmaker has much more serious role in parliament or assembly. Law making is a very serious business, but in our country it is not. So parliamentary business, assembly business will not let you go to your constituency if you seriously focus on law making. This you should know that. It is a flawed perspective in our country that once you become a leader, means member of assembly or parliament, so you will serve to people, you can serve to people by making law rather than directly remaining in contact with public. It is not your duty, it is the duty of administrator. It is the duty of administrator, it is the duty of public employees to remain in contact with people and serve to them. It is the duty of a lawmaker to make law, give direction and play leadership role. That is how you can say, as far as his view analysis, let's say. So that is analysis on that perspective. So since you don't have, if you read your parliamentary things, when you read, you should know that parliamentarians have complained that they don't have time to focus on their business. Although we consider hardly they are even fit for focusing on business, but they don't have time to focus on business, let's say, because every time there is election in our country at certain place, and that result into many other aspects. Anyhow, this is one aspect, let's say that. If you take 2014 debate, so that happened because of Satyapal Singh. So he, let's say, seek early retirement from being a Mumbai police commissioner. And let's say that he seeked retirement and he joined, party, and now he is a minister also. So the debate was because of that, and debate was also because of Vinod Rai. So this debate was because of Vinod Rai. There was, other political parties, especially UPA, she tried to malign his image by saying he had aspiration of politics. Fortunately, unfortunately, he did not join. Right. So that debate was led by them, but you should know that basically when elections come near, so they quit. Other civil servants have also quit and they join politics. Will or should we say that it is opportunism? Is it opportunism or it is really they want to like politics? Politics means good politics. Right, so you can think of this. If you take, before we tell the issues, etc., other countries. So if you take other countries, so basically France, Germany, they have most liberal rules, let's say that, for joining politics. You can join politics. You can even become presidential candidate. If you don't win election, go back to civil service. This kind of system they have. So there, let's say that civil servants can stand in election. If they don't win, so they can be welcome in their institution. With, in France, seniority will be given, but in Germany, seniority will not be given. He will get the equivalent position. He left. So this happened. Basically, let's say if you take Japan, so Japan has a concept of early retirements. Early retirement, generally 50 years of age, they retire. And then there is a concept in Japan that the Japanese government helps civil servants to join private sector, to join politics also. So they have this, so there is no question of basically, let's say that joining politics, because you retire at early stage. That's why over 20% of their legislature members will be civil servant. basically if you take UK has industrial service, non industrial civil service. So industrial service, non industrial. In non industrial there is restriction, in industrial there is no restriction. Those who are part of industrial service, they can join politics. But in part of, let's say, that civil services basically, so they have restrictions. And like we have in India. Similarly, UK, let's say US also, so US has also this, let's say, that kind of system, right, where civil servants have liberty to join politics, but there are some regulations. They can become senator, etc., they can quit civil service, but they don't have system like France and Germany to just then come back. They are the unique country. But should we try to become like them? That is also a question. So should India have, since they have, so many things they have, we try to have, we'll have some other topic where we'll try to link. So should India follow it? As of now, let's say that there is no restriction civil servants joining politics. But civil servant joining business sector, there is 1 year of cooling off period. There is 1 year of cooling off period. So if you talk about rules, so as of now for joining politics, there is no restriction. But there is restriction in All India Services Conduct Rule that if you join business sector after retirement, so certainly you will join after retirement, not before retirement. So after retirement, so there is 1 year of cooling off period. You will join after 1 year. Logic is that since as a civil servant, you have taken many decisions, and therefore if there is no cooling off period, so you can give certain benefit, and after that you can join that organization. So to avoid that kind of give and take, that is how, let's say, this is given. Now you should know that we have All India Services Conduct Rule 2014, which was amended. And there it is mentioned very clearly a principle known as neutrality. So there is a principle, it was not mentioned in past conduct rule. This conduct rule, they have mentioned this explicitly. Right. If they had not mentioned, we could have not been debating. So they have mentioned very explicitly that neutrality is one such principle. Means neutrality is still important, important, you understand what is neutrality. Right. Already these things have been debated in past. Now, Election Commission in 2013 submitted a memorandum to government. But government rejected it. So Election Commission submitted a memorandum to government in 2013, and government rejects. That memorandum was demanding 2 years of cooling off period. It was demanding 2 years of cooling off period. Government says, what government says? It is against constitution. Constitution can be amended, but in this case it is not. It is says it is against constitution. Right. It is government bring Article 14, right, equality. This, then our government brings Article 19, freedom, And government say that it is fundamental right to join politics. So fundamental right will be violated. Right. Government also bring People's Representative Act, means Representation of People Act. Right. This and therefore it has rejected on these grounds. Means restriction of cooling off 2 years, it considers it is not justified. It has said it will not withstand in court of law. There is no law, there is no court. Right. So it will not withstand in court of law. Means kuch law mein unko bahut zyada tension hota hai, kuch law mein nahi hota hai. So this is how they say that. Government rejected, election commission, you know, they have still lots of patience. Right. Again it sent proposal. It again sent the same proposal by replying to their contention. Right. So what was contention? What election commission came? Election commission had good some technical point. Election commission says joining politics and contesting election. The joining politics and contesting election, they are two different things. Right. They say ki we are not seeking them to ban joining election. They can contest election. We are seeking 2 years cooling off period for joining politics. Means political party. Right. It is not this contesting election, it is not fighting for. Right. You can contest as long as independent candidate is relevant in our country. So they have brought two theories, let's say. One is called election, fighting election, and another is joining politics. They say we are against, means cooling off period should be for joining political party, not for contesting election. This then say that both are not fundamental right. They are statutory right, but not fundamental right. Right. So according to election commission, it is statutory right. Right. Representation of People Act. Right. Nowhere in the constitution it is written that you should fight election. No. Or one should have, even Supreme Court has not innovated and given an interpretation that it is fundamental right. So contesting election, etc. So they are more related to Representation of People Act. That's why they are a statutory right rather than it is a fundamental right. And then they say this. Then what government came with this law? The government says that since there is a conflict of interest, right, there is no conflict of interest in politics. Since conflict of interest is involved with business, therefore it is justified. But it is not justified for this case. Right. So government justified this 1 year of cooling off period here in its reply. Right. But in this, it did not justify. Then election commission can say, if it is justified here, it is also justified here. Right. There will also be not conflict of interest. You will give benefit. Here also you are giving benefit. You can give benefit. Now there is no restriction on retiring election commission joining politics. There is no restriction. He is also a civil servant. If he is not a civil servant, so he is more free. So a retiring election commissioner can join politics. So you know, being election commissioner, what he can do? Right. Similarly, let's say that anyone, a CBI director can also join politics. And as a CBI director in let's say last year, so you know what he can do? What one ex-chief justice did? Right. Becoming governor of a state. Right, yes. So if you apply this logic, then you will apply this logic here also. Otherwise it is also not justified. You cannot have this, let's say, if they are serving to business, so they are also serving to politics. In fact, it is more threatening. So election commission sent this proposal. By the time election result came, and you know that thereafter UPA was not there. Thereafter, yeah, they have to send proposal again, but election commissioner also changed. Then, thereafter, they have not sent a proposal, but maybe once election is coming now, nearing, so they will send again a proposal to government. This is how on technicality side of this joining politics. Now, before we take all those contentious issues, let's take that case. Benefits you know already, isn't it? The benefits, they will bring lots of benefits, isn't it? Right. So benefits is that they are professional, trained, that they are efficient, skilled, knowledgeable, as much as words you can add in positive aspect. They are the trained, professional, knowledgeable, skilled, enlightened people. Right. Right. So basically benefits can be classified into three categories. This is how, let's say, governance, democracy, and development. They are the three broad terms, let's say that. Now, the quality of governance will improve. Quality of democracy will improve as clean politics will happen, although Ajit Jogi case it is not. And development, let's say that. Since they have experience with policy making, policy implementation, right. So we can have, let's say, governance, democracy, development. This is how the benefit. Right. As we have, let's say, that many such civil servants in past. If you see, let's say, we gave example of Subhash Chandra Bose, but thereafter you'll find that even Yashwant Sinha, another example, right, something Punya name, let's say, Mani Shankar Iyer. So they can be, let's say, Satyapal Singh, etc., Kiran Bedi, and now Delhi Chief Minister. Right. So all these things you can say that they are the benefits, this is how you can count. So this will bring, and you know, in politics there is a scarcity of good people. So since politics has a scarcity of good people, or let's say good leader, etc., is needed, politics also need, let's say, that expertise, knowledgeable people, right. So that is how, let's say, that it will help, since you have the greater ruralization of parliament. So since Parliament 1970s onwards, so there has been greater ruralization. Largely members are, let's say, highest number of people coming from farming background, right, as against law, politics, economics, etc. If you take the first two, three, let's say, Parliament. So that is how it is said that it will benefit. Means you can write blah, blah, whatever you guess, you will not be. Dearth means having dearth in writing, benefits of civil servants, etc. Main problem is, what are issues? Do we have any issues in that? Read. See, India is not those countries. You have to see Indian scenario. If you take cons or threats, you can count all those problems of the country. Right. India is yet to establish those all, right, brotherhood, harmony, nationhood. It has all sort of problems, caste, religion, region, communal, etc. So all five isms that you say. Right. Communalism, regionalism, casteism, terrorism, nationalism. So they, this is how we have all these things. Then you should know that we have already nexus, corruption. That is said popularly, Neta Babu Lala. Right. If you know proverbial nexus, Neta. And plus. Right. It is not only Neta Babu Lala, but also it is contractor. Right. You can find contractor, criminal. Right. Other aspects. Media also. 2G scam, coal block scam. So you know that the list will go right and expand. So you have nexus, all these things. Plus situation of the country, backwardness. Although we don't consider no longer we are a backward country. Right. So backwardness, poverty, underdevelopment, all these things if you take. In that situation, right. Then if there is always, let's say that you do highest ladder, so you do 10 plus 2, then you go for what? BTEC, management. Then you want to get do for civil services, right, and then you will go for politics, that is ladder. Finally, we don't know whether you will work here or not, right, this is how it is. So basically we do 10 plus 2, then we go for BTEC, MTEC, whatever jo bhi hota hai, no, MBBS, doctor bhi, then. And you are not doing that for sake of becoming a doctor, but for the sake of becoming a civil servant. But again it is not for the sake of being a civil servant. It is again a ladder for politics. Again it is not politics, we can add here president, prime minister, isn't it? So when we will serve, when we will work, right, we are always in a state of planning to work. No, we are always in a state of planning to work. So when we will work, that is a trend you can find in our country. Although it is good, it is not bad if you don't plan to work, you work as the position you hold. But if you don't work as the position, like many people working in PSUs trying for this, good, they are trying for something better. But they are using PSUs as platform. Sorry to say that. Reality is this, that you use the PSU as a platform. So you don't work, give your, let's say that, ki, good, better, best. And then you become civil servant. Again, you are using civil service to pursue a higher end. So you will have a culture of people who will use their position for, right. So if they will not work, you know what will happen. But that's something, let's say that, different level of talk. Basically, let's say that if you take this, most important problem is this. That's why India cannot be this. Because they don't have anyone-ism. No. So they don't have any such issues, let's say. They don't have this. So who will solve those issues? Or we don't need to solve it. So sanctity, this is how it is said that. Means you need to have civil service as an institution which has sanctity. Sanctity of impartiality. And let's say that neutrality. Right. You should know that All India Service was continued to maintain unity and integrity of the country. Right. Objective was this. And Patel says that, right, if you will not have All India Services, So India will not be united. Right. If you want to have unity and integrity of the country, you must have All India Service. This. So we are not concerned, let's say, basically main issue is, other issues you can keep writing, but main issues are that key, sanctity of the institution, civil services, because we are in a different state of, let's say, that affair. Europe may be in a different state and we cannot compare Europe. They have already developed many a time, it is said that if there is a corruption, see, hardly matters. We'll have a topic there, we'll talk you. Witness protection, so a one witness get 33 lakh per year. $60,000. So $60,000 one witness get, we'll come to next topic. Right, so a person when we works as a witness, so you know what happens. So if US is corrupt, so hardly it matters for people. Right. If there is underdevelopment, hardly administration has the burden of development and governance. Right. Because society is already so developed, right, that you don't need to have an administration for bringing transformation. Administration does not have role of bringing transformation. Rather, Facebook alone will do transformation. Right. This is how you can see that. So you don't have a role of administration, but think about this country, right? And when you have such a huge country with huge responsibility, huge issues, all sort of. So if people join politics, it certainly results into making civil service partisan, politicized, which is already politicized. It's not that it is not politicized. It is already politicized. And it makes it further politicized. And then people will have, let's say, political aspirations. And it will be a threat. Already it is a threat, although the trend is not going to. And next is called, already you are going to have lateral entry. So, baad mein agar usko aana bhi hoga civil service mein, to lateral entry to hai, because he was an expert. Right. So, the question is that this is how lateral entry already. So the main important issue is that how to keep civil services impartial, neutral. And that's why, let's say, you cannot stop people to join politics. Since we cannot stop, it is a democracy, liberal democracy we have. Since we cannot stop, so the basic thing can be that you can talk for cooling off period. In nutshell, let's say, going without going to details of this. So there should be a cooling off period. You can talk either of 1 year or 2 years of cooling off period, so that it does not result into opportunism. So that it does not result into when election comes, so then some civil servants resign and they join politics. Because this will give not a right message to the civil services or the serving civil servants. This, although they should join politics, it is not as negative as we are talking about, because we have to save civil service, and there can be other way also, other things also, to make civil service impartial and neutral. There are also other things. If there is a quality of politics, that will itself save the civil service from becoming partisan and, let's say, that discriminatory. Because politics is the most important factor for civil services becoming more partisan, rather than, let's say, that civil servants themselves. There is a very strong point which constrains civil servants that they will not join politics, or there will not be a trend of, let's say, civil servants quitting and joining politics. What is that constraint? First is that all civil servants joining politics are not successful. This you should know that. So you should know Punjab DGP resigned, joined politics, not successful. Similarly, let's say Bihar DGP, let's say in past 4 or 5 years back, he also, let's say, either retired or quit. He contested election, but he lost. So all, let's say that there is a fear. Suppose O.P. Chowdhury can win this time. Right, Kiran Bedi also, but you had governor post. But certainly she will have that is that case, she was not successful. Right. So you can see that example. Yes, good example that even such a, let's say, star civil servant you can say, but she was not successful. So this is one such factor which restrict. The second factor which restricts civil servant joining politics is that they cannot be as flexible as politicians. They cannot be as speaking lies as politicians. Means they cannot stoop to such a low level of politics. Right. Because of the way their personality is, right. They have been trained, they are the professionals. The professionals have certain level of discipline, right, certain level of etiquette, and therefore they will not stoop to a low level of election times, so touching feet also, and touching chin also. No, saying Babu Bhaiya, whatever, let's say that. So they may not stoop to that low level. This is how it is. And this is a second factor. Because in Indian politics, you need to have that kind of people. Right. That kind of people. Otherwise, you know, as I told in theory, a lawmaker is not supposed to go to the constituency. But people if of our country, if you do not go to your constituency and you go next year in elections, so perhaps they can have black flag. No, go back. Because you never visited. This is how. So they want that you keep visiting and keep announcing certain, let's say that key, freebies, lollipop type things, right, so that key, people can remain happy. So these are two major factors. That's why there will not be a trend. So you should not have, let's say, so much worry about this. And your answer, if you write, so you should not become so much, let's say that key, emotional. Right. Past people have joined. You should know when Rajiv Gandhi came to politics, he became prime minister. He forced civil servants to join politics. So four or five civil servants during his time joined politics. That time also there may be debate, I guess. You know, keep civil servants joining politics. Thereafter also every election it happens. So let's say there should be, you should know the different, let's say, dimensions of the issue. But it is not so worrying trend, let's say that we should worry so much because there will not be a trend at all of so many civil servants joining politics. And last aspect is that if you take trends of globalization, means the other countries, so there should be, let's say, quite intermingling. Let's say people should join politics, they should come to civil service, people should join military, they should come to civilian positions. That kind of things happens, so it make people more experienced and more competent. When you have, let's say that interdisciplinary approach today, and if you see from that broad perspective, so people must serve irrespective of which position. But whatever the position they hold, they must serve. Right. That should be the philosophy. They should not use the position for certain benefit. Rather, whatever the position you hold, you must serve. If a civil servant is holding position today, he serves to that professionalism. So tomorrow he joins, so it may not matter. But when we start using it as a platform, as a ladder, then it matters because then let's say that people will not work although they will hold position. So this way, this is how we can tell on this subject. But again, towards end, since integrity, impartiality and neutrality, they are very important because you know that already the environment in the country, the way you say it is partisan discrimination. Right, many such protests happening in different part of the country and investigation, etc. be it Jat protests, be it Koregao protests, be it other such incidents, etc. So you need also at the same time a neutral bureaucracy. That should also be emphasized, and this is how we should tell on this topic.